Good evening, everybody. So, I hope you had a fantastic day. I hope you got a lot accomplished. And I hope you got out of your own way. Because that is the key to success. So, how do you get out of your way? How do you get out of your own way? This is something that everyone, me included, struggles with. Everybody gets stuck up here. Too much thinking, too much contemplating, right? You get so stuck inside your head, inside what's going on, what's the right option, what's the wrong option, how should I do this, how should I not do this, right? We get so stuck in our own head that it creates analysis paralysis. You have so many things you're thinking about that you don't take action. So here's how I get out of my own way. So when I catch myself overthinking things, what I do is I hit go. So let's say it's on a Facebook Live. If I'm staring at my phone thinking, what do I talk about? I'll just write, hi, and then hit go live and start talking. See, you've got to figure out what works for you. See, that works for me. I just take action. That is how I get out of my own way. What's gonna work for you is probably gonna be different, but you've got to figure out what will work for you to get out of your own way. What will work for you to move forward, move past this place of stagnation, this place where you feel so stuck? Because the most important thing for you to do is figure out how to break through that barrier, how to go and go further, faster. Key to success is not being right all the time. It's failing fast. That is the key to success. The really successful people out there have failed more times than the unsuccessful people have even tried. That is the key to success, is failure. How do you fail? You try stuff. You put it out there. You hit go. You hit share. You just tell someone about it. You've got to start. So that is what you have to do if you want to be successful. You've got to get out of your own way. You've got to stop focusing on what could go wrong, because everything can go wrong. I promise you. But it could also go right. See, here's the thing. When you get stuck thinking in your head, you're, what if someone looks at me and calls me ugly? Right? Who cares? What if they look at you and think, man, that is the most handsome devil I've ever seen. What a Greek god, right? Hey, you make up your own lies. Why not make them positive? So you've got to figure out how to break through those barriers. What's going to work for you? Because what works for me doesn't work for everybody else. Figure out what works for you to get you unstuck, to get you over that hump. Exactly, Colton. Burn the boats. You've got to let go of safety in order to get to where you deserve to be. If you don't figure out how to do that, you will forever live in a place of safety. You will forever live in a place of comfort. And I promise you, you deserve better. So what you have to do is get through the barriers. Do something incredibly uncomfortable. If it terrifies you, that's a good indication that you should do it. I'm not talking about like jumping off bridges, because that shit terrifies me. I'm talking about taking action in business. I'm talking about pick up the phone, call someone, be like, hey, I was just thinking about you. I know we haven't talked in a while. How's it going? Just take action. You don't even have to try and get to any sort of outcome. You just have to start. It's called 5 seconds of courage. Dial the phone number and put it to your ear. Something will happen. But it won't happen if you don't dial. So figure out what works for you. What do you need to do in order to break through those barriers? What do you need to do to get what you deserve? And in order to get what you deserve, you must learn how to fail. Because failure is the key to success. The best thing you can ever do for failure, for business, is fail. Because I promise you, I've had sales calls that went really good. I didn't learn much. I felt great. I've had sales calls that went really bad. Really, really bad. And I learned a ton. I wouldn't learn those lessons if I closed the business. See, failure is the breeding ground for success. And so many people are terrified of failing. But failure's really what's going to take you to where you deserve to be. So here's my challenge for you. I want you to fail, not on purpose, but I want you to go out and I want you to work hard and I want you to do something incredibly uncomfortable. I don't know what it is, you have to decide that. But I want you to do something with the mindset that I will most likely fail at this. Because by failing, you will learn and you will get better. See, no one starts out good. I've looked back at some of my past videos. I did not start out good. I've got a long ways to go before I get to expert level, but I feel like I'm good now, right? My past videos, if you looked at just a year ago, you'd be like, oh my God, this guy is so boring. Yeah, because I stood there and I was professional. And I told people, you know, in sales, you need to be serious and you need to really help people. Not entertaining, right? Not good. But I did it. I failed and I failed often. And by failing, I got better. Slowly, I got better and better and better because I failed. Because I did videos that were so pathetic, so bad. And that's just one example. So if you want to be great, fail. Own failure. Live with failure. Figure out, another challenge, figure out what you failed on today. Think about it. There is something that you failed to do today. What is it? And what did you learn from it? See, failure is only bad. Well, failure is only failure if you don't get up and try again first. But it's only bad if you don't learn from it. Failure is the greatest teaching tool ever. I mean, if you don't fail, you're not gonna ever learn. So, two challenges. One, what are you gonna fail at tomorrow? What are you gonna get wildly outside of your comfort zone and just try? And just try and be ridiculously bad and own it. What? Comment below, I'd love to hear. And second, what did you learn from a failure you had today? Think about it, because every single one of us fail every day. I promise you. It may not be an epic failure, but you must fail. You must. So please, I'm begging you, own it. Own that failure, because that failure is so key to your growth. That failure is when you want to curl up in a little ball and cry. I can think of a couple nights 2-3 weeks ago where I felt that way. I learned a ton from it though. So, I love you guys, but I want you to fail. And I want it not because I want you to be a failure. There is a big difference, by the way. I just started this business, right? The reason I was able to is because I know that I could fail. I also know by failing does not make me a failure. Huge difference between failing and being a failure. You are not a failure, but I want you to fail. Because by failing, you will grow, you will learn, you will be so much better. So go out. I love you guys. Go out and fail. Do it for you. Don't do it for me. Do it because you deserve the best in life. And the best in life does not come from winning every game. The best in life comes from losing and then getting back up again and pushing harder. So comment below, share with me, how can I help? What are you struggling with? What do you need help with? What are you failing with? Because all those things are things that everybody goes through. And we can all learn together. Because I promise, I'm not perfect. I fail. I try to fail at least 3 times a day. Because that's good for me, right? Keeps my ego in check. Keeps me down to earth. Failure's a great thing. But it's hard. So get great at failure and you will go to amazing places. Okay. I love you guys. If I can help, reach out. I'm here. I am here for you. I am here to help. We'll see you later.